In Masechet Sota, the Gemara stated that Rabban Yohanan ben Zakkai prohibited Kohanim from ascending a platform to recite Birkat Kohanim while wearing their shoes. The Gemara explained that if they wore their shoes and their shoelaces became untied, that they might leave the platform to tie them, which could lead to a suspicion that they left the platform because they are not valid Kohanim. Rashi explained that it's unbecoming for one to have their shoelaces untied in front of everyone, and people might chide them because it doesn't look nice. Therefore, Harambam ruled that Kohanim may not ascend the platform with their shoes on, that they recite the blessing barefoot. Maran also ruled that Kohanim may not ascend the platform with their shoes on. However, he did permit reciting the blessing while wearing socks. The later authorities addressed the question of whether Kohanim are still obligated to remove their shoes if they recite the blessing without ascending a platform. Since the reason for removing shoes only applies to a Kohen who ascended a platform, making his shoes visible to the congregation, several authorities wrote that the requirement does not apply to those that recite the blessing without ascending a platform, meaning that by remaining on ground level, his untied shoelaces would not be noticeable, and he would not feel compelled to tie them before reciting the blessing. Rabbi Yitzhak Palachi, who lived in Turkey in the 19th century, wrote in his book Yefe Leleb, this is a copy of that book, that the requirement of removing shoes only applies to Kohanim who ascend the platform. This was also the opinion of Rabbi Yehoshua Perahya Kohen in his book Vayikra Yehoshua. He also lived in the 19th century, but he was from Salonika. And it was also the opinion of Rabbi Yaakov Moshe Toledano in his response to Yom HaGadol, and the opinion of the former chief rabbi of Israel, Rabbi Yitzhak Nissim, in his response to Yen HaTov. They also cited the fact that the Gemara used the term La'alot LaDuchan, to ascend a platform, as opposed to the more common term for Birkat Kohanim of Lisat Kapehen, to raise their hands, when stipulating the requirement of removing shoes. Rabbi Yitzhak Nissim wrote that in his times, in the beginning of the 20th century, there were Kohanim in Baghdad and Egypt that did not ascend the platform to recite Birkat Kohanim, and therefore they did not remove their shoes. The book Derech Eretz also recorded this as the custom of Halab, and this custom continued here in the community as well, as attested to by Acham Baruch ben Chaim Alav Shalom in a recorded class from the year 1964. It has also been reported that Acham Atub Abadi Alav Shalom taught that Kohanim are required to remove their shoes if they ascend a platform that is at least 3 tefahim high, which is 9.5 inches, but they may ascend a platform that is less than 3 tefahim high with their shoes on to recite Birkat Kohanim. So the custom of reciting Birkat Kohanim while wearing shoes is valid, provided the Kohen does not ascend a platform that is at least 9.5 inches high. This is based on the opinion of several later authorities, and was the accepted practice in several Middle Eastern communities, including Halab. This custom also continued here in New York with the approval of the leading community rabbis.